This episode of the Old Dogs REI Network is brought to you by Mino Studio.
In a world where jobs are how most people make money, one man, one desire, one challenge dares to break the mold. Welcome to the Old Dogs REI Network, where we don't work for money. Money works for us. Coming soon, viewer discretion advised.
Welcome to the Old Dogs REI Network, where cash flow is king. Real estate investing, the means, so you can enjoy your retirement dreams. This is the show where we cut right to the chase. No sales pitch, no long monologues, just simple how-to real estate investing advice, so you can earn the passive income you need to enjoy your retirement today. And now, your host and chief old dog, Bill Manassero.
Welcome to the Old Dogs REI Network. I'm your host, Bill Manassero, and this is a show where 50-plussers and anyone else who wants to join us get solid, no-sales-pitch real estate investing advice to help generate real cash flow. This podcast airs twice weekly on Mondays and Fridays, and if you aren't already a subscriber, go to iTunes, type in Old Dog, spelled D-A-W-G, find our podcast, and subscribe. Well, today we're going to be moving in an interesting area. We've got a great guy here who is from a company that is involved with direct mail, but not just any kind of direct mail. Their whole focus is postcards. I know that we've talked about direct mail in the past on previous podcasts and some of our blog articles. This is a really key area because one of the things that we do as real estate investors is to try to find that diamond in the rough. And that diamond in the rough is a property that is owned by somebody who hasn't listed it for sale as of yet. And that's really a hard thing to find sometimes. But direct mail is the way to uncover some of those gems. So our guest today is Barry Coziahr. He is the national speaker for PostcardMania, a full-service postcard marketing company specializing in lead generation. He's also the host of a small business marketing podcast, Real Live Marketing. So this is a guy that knows marketing here. And he's trained and consulted more than 10,000 small business owners and delivered over 1,000 seminars and workshops to small businesses across the United States. His presentations demonstrate proven marketing tactics using real-world examples and case studies to help small businesses and nonprofits market themselves successfully. Postcard Mania offers a complete marketing campaigns to companies of all sizes, from small businesses to large enterprises. Postcard Mania's campaigns are fully turnkey and include a whole host of services. In addition, they're educating the 70,000-plus small business clients that they have with free marketing advice. Postcard Mania has been featured on the Inc. 500 and 5,000 lists, as well as Forbes.com. Well, Barry, welcome to the Old Dogs REI Network.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it. Awesome to be here, Bill.
It's a pleasure to have you on here. This is an area we really just have not spent enough time. In fact, marketing in general, I don't think we've spent enough time on. So we'll tap into some of your marketing expertise as well.
Sure. Ask me anything. Whatever. Try to stump me.
You got it, Barry. Well, first off, just, you know, why don't you tell, and I gave kind of a bio there, but maybe you can tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got involved in marketing.
Sure. Yeah. Well, my dad was a salesman. I mean, he worked in the clothing industry, selling suits, and then being the buyer, traveling all over the country as a buyer for one of those large clothing department stores back in the day called Schrasky's in Peoria, Illinois, right?
Wow.
All places. Yeah, exactly. And And so, you know, I got the sales bug early, and I was out knocking on doors, door to door, selling stuff for school and such at the age of 7. I started winning my first contests. You know, contests are great. Oh, look, you get prizes for selling the stuff for free for the school as well. So that was some of my first experiences. You know, as I grew up, my dad became an entrepreneur, started his own businesses, had some setbacks and some incredible successes as a salesperson, and opened his own business, was very much into helping a lot of people, had actually a number of small businesses in Peoria and East Peoria, Illinois, and which, you know, where I grew up. I started working for him, helping him with advertising, getting involved in sales, learning all the ins and outs of that business, and then starting my own sales career, and not long after starting my own business. In fact, I worked in nonprofit as well. I see that you've done quite a bit of missionary work specifically, right? Is what you've done. And I've worked, I spent a lot of time working in nonprofit too, helping out. So I guess the things I learned from my dad was sell, hire people, take care of them, and give back, all of which I've, you know, made part of my life.
Ah, that's excellent. Well, this is great. I'm glad you're on the show, and you know, love to be able to sort of dig into this area of direct marketing and all the ramifications associated with that. So maybe just give me just a little rundown why, you know, Postcard Mania as a company, what kinds of advantages they're dealing with, a sort of a full service company like that.
Sure. I mean, I've worked here at Postcard Mania, working with and for them, involved in the education and consulting people. But I've actually known about Postcard Mania for well over a decade. The company's been around since about 1998. And I ran into Postcard Mania because well before it was cool to do so, Joy Gendusa, who's the CEO, it's a privately held company still. Right, and she's grown this $50 million a year company with over 200 employees, and it's still privately owned without any capital investment, without any angel investors or anything. She just grew it using marketing, and I thought it was really impressive, even a decade ago, how far she'd grown the place just using marketing. And before it was cool, she was giving away marketing knowledge to help small business owners before we talked about content like we do today. A decade ago, you know, I mean, the internet was really just coming into its being, you know, full-flown force. Social media has really started coming into existence, the whole deal. She was already giving away content, had written her a book on postcard marketing, which was fantastic. And I actually used that book to help a lot of clients with postcards because she really detailed the process to empower her clients so that they could, you know, use successful techniques and be successful themselves. So it's a pretty amazing company from that perspective. And then we work with a number of industries where we really dig in and catalog what actually works. So we have an actual type of offer that works. This is the type of postcard that works. This is the type of mailing list. You know, just right across the boards. And one of those industries is real estate investment. And it's great that we actually have somebody here full time. All they do is dig in and find out what's working and what's not working in direct mail with regards to this particular industry and a number of others. So Postcard Mania is pretty unique in that respect. We don't just sell postcards. You actually can't go on our website and order postcards. You have to talk to a consultant who's going to work with you and help you figure out exactly what's going to work campaign-wise and get a result for you. So it's really unique in a number of different ways.
Well, I've never dealt with Postcard Mania. In fact, you know, I've done very little direct mail related to real estate. I was a marketing guy and had advertising agency and all that stuff years ago, but I haven't worked with them. So this is really, I'm asking questions just like any potential customer would. So I can't really testify to, as to, you know, the things that you guys do, but I was very impressed with the comprehensive approach. I'm, you know, one of the things that is really key in real estate, it's a little competitive out there right now, especially in the multifamily arena. And so we like to be able to go, if possible, direct to seller, direct to owner, and to be able to give that profile. For example, my ideal owner, so to speak, would be an individual who has, it's maybe a family or a mom and pop type property that they've owned for a while, that, you know, maybe they've owned it at least 10 years or 20 years, that, you know, maybe they're managing it from a different state, for example, or, you know, there are just certain elements that you put together, you know, looking for a B grade, a B class property. And to be able to define all this criteria and then to say, okay, now give me a list.
Right.
You know, that's not always easy. And, you know, I know there are list providers, you know, professional list providers, but that's also something you guys do as well. Is that correct?
Absolutely. I mean, we've spent a lot of time looking for the best list providers out there, because you can buy bad lists, and lists need to be guaranteed. And really, there are not a ton of resources out there that you can count on 100% of the time. So we've really nailed it. We've got those resources, and that's part of the service that we offer. And we not only do the consulting, but then we help you figure out what list you should be buying. We help you to acquire that list for you. Just buy it from us. We do the design work, the printing, the mailing. We even have an office here in our facility for the United States Postal Service to speed up mail for our clients.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's pretty interesting.
That's interesting.
Yeah, the post office has an office here. That's how much direct mail we send, right?
Wow.
So we have some great list products, including we started working with and we sell the service for a company called Benutech or Rebo Gateway.
Mm-hmm.
This is a service that helps to get into things like divorce, probates, all sorts of different stuff. We're really able to zero in on that list, and that's one of the services that we use that can zero in and get the ideal list. Because the list is the thing, you know. You got to have. I mean, any marketing action starts with a good list. Even if, you know, no matter what it is you're trying to sell, you really got to name out who it is that you want to prospect and reach out to, you know, and that's where it all starts. And then it gets into, you know, the offer and how's it presented and how frequently you present it. And so we love to consult on all those things.
So you work with your customers with sort of a target audience profile, sort of first off, so you know who it is you're going after.
Absolutely. Yeah. And maybe you have some idea, but we also have some good advice and we can zero in as far as that list goes to help you figure out exactly who it is that you want to be going after.
Yeah. Because I would imagine the design of that card would, again, you'd want to appeal to the specific attributes of that target audience. So I would think that having to define that person would be really key, or those persons that might be potential.
Yeah, exactly. It depends. There are a lot of different lists. You know, there's absentee owners, abandoned properties, probates, foreclosures. Obviously, the apartment owners is a big deal, and you know, even expired listings, right? In the land of real estate investment. And so, yeah, designing that card's a big deal. The card might be a color card, or there's even a good yellow and black card that works really good. You may have heard of people sending out yellow letters.
Right.
Well, we do, you know, and there's some guys that recommend, you know, sending out at least 20 letters a day, 5 days a week for 6 months in order to get a result. Okay, well, that's a great technique and it will get you a result. Now, if you could do more, just like with any other marketing tool, the more you send out, the more leads you have coming in. So, well, we could actually print that stuff for you and send it out. We can even make some of the fonts look handwritten.
Well, I mean, you've probably tested out a lot of different things. So I imagine you have a real good crew there in terms of experience that can probably recommend things that have a stronger pull than others.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, we know exactly what actually works. we really dig in on that. We're able to tell you exactly how often you should mail, the whole deal.
Yeah, you know, as I've been researching lists and various options out there, it was interesting because I just pick up my own mail and I look at the items that are in there, and there's a fair amount of junk mail, so to speak, but it's those big postcards that seem, you got to look at them. They're big, they're full color, they've got, and it's so easy. You don't have to open anything. You just look at it, flip it over. And it really does draw your attention right off the bat. Whereas I get an envelope, don't really know who it's from, and it's not anybody that I know just by looking at it at a glance. It's questionable whether I'm going to even open that envelope sometime.
It's true. That's the beauty of postcards. It's like you can't help but get the marketing message, as you're flipping through that mail. Our designers actually have like a 10-point checklist that they go through on any postcard, whether we design it or not, including the very first thing being the headline. The headline has to jump off that postcard and actually communicate exactly what it is that you're offering, because 2 out of 10 people just read the headlines, right? For starters, they'll be flipping through and that headline has to communicate so that you can pull them in and get them to read the rest of the card. So yeah, that's a big deal. And postcards are perfect for that. You can't do that with a letter.
Now, do you have any stats that compare postcard response to letter response?
We actually have a program on our website because every product's different. People ask about how many responses they get. Well, we actually have a program on the website called an ROI calculator, return on investment calculator. And Joy talks about this in her book, and I'm actually going to send you a link where you're people can grab a copy of her book for free.
That's great.
Yeah, we'll get you a copy of that, plus a couple other reports on real estate investment, including like what's been working, some of the things I'm talking about here. But the big thing is return on investment is what you want to look at when you're looking at any advertising campaign. Not necessarily how many responses you get, but whether or not the responses are going to pay off. Like, for instance, I have a decking contractor that I'll do, I've done direct mail with. He actually knows that if he gets 3 leads, he's going to close one of them, and that one sale will pay for his whole postcard campaign, a rather large postcard campaign. So all he really needs is one close to fully cover his campaign and to load it up again. Rather than look at the number of leads that you get, we actually have a calculator on our website that'll help you figure out the return on investment so you can calculate, okay, well, how many people do I need to respond? How many do I need to close? What's the lifetime value of that relationship? And it'll help you calculate out everything so you can figure out what you need that postcard campaign to produce. And then we'll give you some real statistics about what's actually happening in your industry and in your area in some cases, so that you can make the most of your money, basically.
The thing that I was looking for were sort of a percentage comparison to postcard versus letter.
Let's say you're going to do a letter, right? Which I recommend a postcard any day over a letter. But if you're going to do a letter, you really want to do letters that are like, that have some sort of maybe bulky item in it. And there's all sorts of tricks to getting an envelope opened, right? And even using the outside of the envelope as part of your promotional tool, right? Using the outside of the envelope. But wow, that's a lot of work to go to like, to get what you can get with a postcard. With a postcard, the postage is cheaper. Can be really cheap if you're just blanketing a neighborhood. You can get really cheap with the postage. You also don't have the added expense of paying not only for the whatever goes inside the envelope, but those are the advantages to using a cost, a convenience, ability to do it repetitively, which is important. Those are the advantages of using a postcard for sure over anything that goes in an envelope.
Yeah, and I mean, I think there's also some negatives too, in that some people, when they receive a lot of mail, that you have a tendency to take, those things that are the newsprint, like you get from supermarkets and those types of things, and they may lump them in with postcards, which they are something that they're, they they know that isn't something specifically a bill they have to deal with or some sort of correspondence they have to deal with. So they may lump those together and, you know, move them into the recycler there. I think probably more advantages than disadvantages, but there are definitely some disadvantages as well.
Yeah. I mean, we send out envelope stuff here, too. We have a whole section of the organization that deals with you know, enveloped mail. So we'll send out those yellow letters for you, too. Here's an example of a card that was sent out. We had a customer scheduled for 6 months, about a little over 1,000 postcards. And he got 20 calls after the first mailer, like some sort of like 11% response rate. And he closed 12 of them. The revenue was about $200,000, but it was to an absentee list. I mean, it was just an incredible return on investment. But that was just one of those little yellow cards.
Right. Well, that's great. That's great. Yeah, I would imagine that there are just really good numbers. I think that the thing that's really key, I think, with any direct mail campaign is one, how do you get them to respond? So is there an 800 number? Is there a website? Is one better than the other? And what happens when they call that number or what happens when they go to that website? I mean, that's, you know, you can have your whole campaign go out the window if you don't have a way to effectively be able to follow up and to respond. So have you noticed whether or not it's better to have a phone number or to have a website, for example?
Well, I've got both examples here in the report that I'm going to make available to you, which will show some case studies. Anybody can download. I have one guy, all he has is a phone number. He was able to purchase from us a special phone number that was a tracking phone number and that would actually track and show him what responses were coming directly from that postcard. And he only had a phone number and he basically got a whole campaign that he did around that. And he got a great response. He got like over 3,000% return on his investment. Yeah, it's just fantastic. The other one is up in Detroit, and there's a little bit of property available in Detroit, I hear. not necessarily a good scene, but there is property available, and you could help some people up there, actually, too. And there's a company called Boost Detroit, but they actually have a website and a phone number. Now, so both these guys are getting, and they got like 11,000% return on investment, which they get even higher return on investment. So even though they both did well, it would kind of tend to towards having a website if you were to look at these percentages of profit and return on investment. Now, if you have a website, you want to make sure it's a good website that's going to work on a phone. It's going to be responsive. You want to have a good contact form there, and you want to have enough good and interesting information that's going to keep them there and some sort of reason for them to give up their information. A lot of people are doing their research via the web before they even pick up a phone. So I would tend towards having a website. We actually design websites here because a good website can make or break a direct mail campaign in some cases. So we'll put together a landing page or a full-blown website pretty inexpensively.
Personally, I think that a website, it just, because it's automated, it is, if it's designed right, it probably would be very effective. I think when you've got a phone call, you've got one, the issue of a live person answering or having to leave a message or be routed to where you need them to be routed. I would say the less likely of a live person dealing with it, I think the less it just takes away. I think people get a message or you know, where they've got to leave a message or something, you're losing people. I personally think a website is more effective, but I'm sure there are people that have got the phone thing down too.
There's definitely some examples here in this report that I'm going to make available of guys who just have a phone number, but there's more examples of people that have both a phone number and a website. One of the post office statistics I saw was 95% of people will go to your website before they pick up the phone, of interested people. And so that kind of says that you better have a website available and it better be a decent one that's actually going to get a good result for you. So it definitely, there's lots of reasons it would seem to have a decent website in place.
You guys probably deal with, I would imagine, your share of Fortune 500 type companies. But, you know, are there folks that are listening here are generally not for, you know, Fortune 500 people. They're, sure. you know, they're regular Joes or small business people, or maybe just investors, and they may not even have a formal business entity yet. But, you know, can they even afford the kind of service that you guys provide? And realistically, what are you talking about in terms of costs? And I know I'm putting you on the spot here because it would vary depending, but I think the people listening are going to want to know, you know, is this something that is even in my possibility in terms of what I'm looking to do here?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you're going to have to market somehow or another. You're either going to invest, you know, some money or some time, or probably both, right? But you should know that most of our clients are not the Fortune 500 types. 99% of our clients are, you know, independent individuals who have a small business like your listeners. And are looking to grow that business. And we have a good number of people that are doing real estate investment that use our service, and they're successful doing it too. What I would suggest, and a mistake would be, to not plan out to do it for long enough to get a result. Plan on doing repetitive mailings long enough to get a result. Joy sent out postcards here at Postcard Mania. We've not missed a single week of sending out postcards since 1998. Hurricanes, no matter what, right? And she started small. She started with 1,000 postcards a week. And then every time her income got to a new plateau, she increased the amount of marketing she was doing. She increased the number of postcards. And right now, we send out about 180,000 postcards a week. Right? It was a lot of postcards. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're totally in it to help people start small with those smaller campaigns. Maybe they need to do 1,000 a month, 1,000 a week, whatever it is. We're used to working with small business owners. That's who we care for.
Do you have a minimum order?
As far as like how many they can mail out at a time, there are minimum requirements that the post office actually has in order to get the best possible postage rate. So we make sure your mailing's within those requirements, which a consultant can go over with you and help you figure out.
Okay, so you don't have a number for me?
Last I checked the statistics, minimum was like 500 postcards that'd be mailed at a time, 2 to 500 to get the best possible postage rate.
Okay, and those are bulk rates you're talking about?
That's right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and it depending on the type of your mailing that you're doing, that number could vary a bit.
What kind of costs are involved for the small business person to do this?
Okay. For postcards, it could be as little as, you know, less than a nickel a piece for the postcards. Postage rates vary. They, depending on the type of mailing that you do, it can range to around 18 cents a piece for postage, up to, you know, 27 or a little bit more per piece. And then design can be a little bit of nothing for a design. You know, even if, you know, like if you're doing one of these little yellow postcards, I mean, that's really not much of any time involved at all. So a little bit of cost there. And then, of course, your list, if you need one. And list prices vary depending on what type of list that you have. I wouldn't be able to really tell you exactly a cost on that.
Okay. You mentioned also too that you do the sort of the fully integrated campaign, which would mean if there is an 800 number or if there is a website, that you guys would actually manage that as well. Is that how I read that correctly?
Yeah, that's right. We do pay-per-click advertising, which I know people that have used pay-per-click in conjunction with direct mail and gotten some good results in the, you know, in the REI, you know, arena, as well as we can help hook you up with a phone number that's tracked phone number. We can definitely help you with a website. The whole enchilada. You know, we're a full service company. We even do logos. If you need a logo for your company.
Now, I'm sure you've heard many stories on the direct mail front here. What would you say, you know, is sort of one of the big mistakes that people make when it comes to direct mail?
Well, they didn't experience here, but I do know of a guy who bought a list and like 50% of it was undelivered and it was sent back. Still cost him all his postage money and everything. We actually have like a 90% guaranteed on our lists.
And what would you say is sort of your biggest success? I mean, I know you mentioned the Boost Detroit, but you know, is there a particular campaign that you recall that really showed the effectiveness of postcards?
Sure. I mean, there's a number of them. Let's see if I can think of one specifically. I mean, I know that, yeah, that Boost Detroit was pretty amazing, like 11,000% return on investment. There is a gentleman right now who's been doing a campaign with us, and it's actually the only marketing he's doing. He's actually doing one of those yellow postcards, actually, just like, you know, like we were talking about, another one of those. His campaign's pretty fantastic, really working well for him. I'll pull it up right here. But he's only sending out those type of postcards. And here it is. He started with a targeted list of distressed properties, about 7,200 at a time. And the result is he's making about $60,000 to $100,000 per month. You know, he's he's generating just under between $60,000 and $100,000 revenue every month, and all he's doing is postcards. He's sending out like 15,000 postcards per month, and he's got a little over a 3,000% return on investment, and that's just all he does. He's got this machine set up, and I mean, that's really good money, you know, for somebody in this doing this particular type of work.
And now, is he a wholesaler?
Yeah, he's a wholesaler.
Oh, okay. Great, yeah. Great. Cool. Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Well, what kind of advice would you have for our audience? These are folks that are just starting to look, some of them have been doing it for a while and already, you know, are active investors, but what kind of advice would you have for somebody who's just starting out and maybe this is their first taste of direct mail?
Well, I mean, I'd read up on the subject to get really comfortable with what you're doing. The Postcard Mania website has some great reports that you can read through, and you know, we'll offer to everybody Joy's book. I'd read it, you know, I'd study up on the subject.
Well, this has been some great information here. We're running kind of near the end of our interview here, but we're going to have our wrap it up session where I ask you a series of quick questions and just on resources and information that you might be able to provide for those that might be interested here. So if you're ready, I can go ahead and start with those questions. Are you ready, Barry?
I'm ready.
All right. Favorite business book?
Sure. There's a book called 80-20 Sales and Marketing by a guy named Perry Marshall. And he digs into the 80-20 principle, how, you know, 20% of what you want comes from, or 80% of the income would come from 20% of the resources, is one example. It's a great book on sales. Also, to teach you how to use your time better so that you're spending more of your hours making $1,000 an hour and less of them making 10 or 20 bucks an hour.
I love it. How about your most valuable website for success other than your own?
Other than Postcard Mania?
Yeah.
The one I'd recommend is Amazon or the Barnes & Noble website, really, and just go in, because I think books are, you know, important. And digging in and reading about sales and marketing. And Amazon also owns audible.com, which is a book on tape resource. And so I would say that because, you know, I think you should have a decent library and you should be reading constantly so that you know what's going on and you can, you know, make the most of yourself.
I love it. Yeah, I'm a big fan of Audible. Yeah. How about favorite app?
My favorite app at the moment is Evernote.
It's great.
It's a great tool. Yeah. It's and I'd highly recommend if anybody wants to write me personally, BarryC@postcardmania.com. I'll send you my favorite tutorial about Evernote, because people don't use Evernote because they don't take long enough to understand it. It takes a few minutes to get how it works, but it's a great storage facility for notes and ideas, photos, recordings. I mean, really just tons of stuff, and it's so searchable. It's like the ultimate organized tool for the unorganized person.
I love it. How about your favorite quote?
Favorite quote? I guess Ricky Bobby said, if you're not first, you're last.
I love it. Ricky Bobby. Well, it's so deep. Okay. All right. So
there's also another good book out there based on that. It's a quote. I forgot about the quote question, but it's just a good one. I guess the other quote that comes to mind now that I got a second to think is, I'll give you one more. Einstein had a great quote about that. If you can understand something really, really well, you can explain it to a 6-year-old. That's how well you should understand your industry. So you can explain it to somebody that young.
Oh, that's great. Great. And final question here. If you, let's say there was something catastrophic that happened, that you lost everything and all you had was $1,000 in cash, what would you do with that $1,000 to restore everything you lost?
Well, I guess I'd make sure that I bought some clothes and made myself personally presentable so that I could go out and sell something, because and maybe buy a book on how to sell if I didn't already know how to do that. Because I mean, I consider that, that's why I keep talking about books and stuff, because I think that your most valuable, one of your most valuable resources, if not your most valuable resource, is yourself, because then that's what stability comes from, and you can use that to reach out and help other people.
I love it. Great. So how can folks find out more about Postcard Mania?
Sure. I mean, well, one of the things is, if you're interested, you can call in right now and talk to a consultant. You can reach out to us at 855 980-5492. Or you can write me, Barry C, B-A-R-R-Y-C, at postcardmania.com, and I'll connect you with somebody. And then we'll also have some link to some reports. You can check us out via our website. But yeah, write me or give us a call there.
Excellent. Thank you. And the time just kind of zipped by here, and I tried to fit all the questions I could in there, but I still have some. But nonetheless, I need to let you go, and we need to move on here. But we do have a way we close out our show, and I warned you in advance. So we're going to have you, Barry, just give us your best old hound dog howl to just close out our show today.
Good. Ow.
All right. you did it, Barry. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, sir.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being on, Barry. And a lot of great information here. We will have a link to this book that Barry is talking about in our show notes. So if you guys are interested in getting that book that he's saying we can get for free, I mean, hey, we're into free stuff. We love free stuff. So you can access it through our website at olddogsreinetwork.com. That is it for today. We want to thank Barry for his time today. I want to thank all you old dog listeners out there, too, for listening and joining us today. We know there's a lot of other things you could be doing right now, but the fact that you've taken the time to join us means a lot. We greatly appreciate it. Everything that Barry mentioned today will be in our show notes. There will be a summary of what he spoke about, as well as the links as well. So you can, again, get that at the Old Dogs website at olddogsreinetwork.com/blog. And just look for the episode with Barry. Well, that's it for today. Remember, cash flow is king, and real estate investing the means. Until next time, keep moving forward, and may God bless.
Thank you very much for visiting the Old Dogs REI Network. We would greatly appreciate if you would stop by iTunes and let us know what you think of the show. We would love if you could subscribe to the podcast, give us a 5-star rating, and write a review. The more ratings and reviews we receive, the more visible the podcast will be to others. Thank you.